I was just going through your Twitter timeline and some of your interviews. I think you're quite a philosopher. You like just quoting from Socrates and Nietzsche and James Dean and all sorts of people.
Of course, I think in last few years I've realized that all opinions I had, there's no truth to it, or they are very abstract.
Right.
And then also interacting with Diwakar and Shekhar over the last 1.5-2 years.
Right. Shekhar Kapoor.
Kapoor is when I realized, okay, so we have these strong opinions because of what we believe in, but just because we don't know so many things about so many things is why we are so, you know, kind of, we are holding on to those opinions. Right. So I started opening up, maybe. That's why.
I watched Kedarnath. The confusion about the religious identity in a way, and be the class divide. There's a lot of subtlety in your performance. Would you like to talk about that?
I think it's very recently that I realized one thing, that we all act all the time. I'm not saying act in terms of that we lie all the time, but I'm saying that we generally act all the time. And as an actor, what I used to do in films is that we are told not to act, make it natural. Well, that's a great way to go. But then I thought my characters, just like me, could also act in front of my co-characters. So when you think like that, then you try to cut down your emotions so that the other co-character does not. If you don't want them to know, then you're cutting down on emotions, and what you're left with on your face are just those small nuances.
We've seen quite a few actors who played cricketers or various other sports. Some have been convincing, some maybe have not been that convincing. But this is, it looks like 100% convincing that entire, the way the helicopter shot is going, is something brilliant. So if you can talk about the learning part, that hunger for learning that Dhoni has.
First thing, the hunger for learning. Mm. I mean, like, I can totally connect with that. I have started from nothing, absolutely nothing. It's not even zero, it's like minus. Because I was doing something else. There was a momentum to become an engineer, and suddenly I discovered this thing that I really like. Mm. And I start doing it. But at the same time, as a kid, I also had many dreams, like common dreams. You know, I'll buy my own house and I'll buy this car, it's a luxury car. So these things were there. And now when I started following my dream, in the sense of changing my career, I started earning money to an extent that I could actually afford all these things.
What one expects from a period movie is in terms of the color, but there's a lot of thrill element into it. That I think the pace, at least on the promos, it's very, very fast paced. And you're saying that it's primarily catering to the youthful audience.
Of course, I don't think it has changed since last 60 years. I think the most fundamental thing that should be there in a film, especially of this genre, is if you can sustain the idea of what's going to happen next. So that's the first thing that we, as a filmmaker, you get to learn. Okay, this is something that should be consistent in a film. So Sharadindu's stories, all the 31 and 32, it's got a style, and he is able to maintain that thing. So everything that he has done with the script, everything, all the things that you were saying, that okay, there's a Japanese invasion happening, there is Chinese guys, there are American GIs in the film, there is an opium trade in the film,
right.
There is a Calcutta underworld very thriving at that point of time, there is Indian National Army. So these are the things that were there in Calcutta at that point of time. Mm-hmm. Also because of Sharadindu, what he has written, so he has kept the essence alive, he has kind of created that consistent what if, what next thing in the film. Mm-hmm. I think it doesn't change whether it's 1940s or it's a story of 70s or 2050.
If you could meet any historical figure, who would it be?
Mr. Gandhi.
Why?
I find his ideologies very, very exciting. More exciting than what I thought as a kid when I was reading what he did. So now I understand its value. Just not in moral and moral sense or ethics sense, but also in terms of getting people together and making them good individually and as a team.
Ek shabd mein jawab. लखना और सुशांत सिंह राजपूत की एक कॉमन आदत.
डरते नहीं है
राजपूत.
इसलिए नहीं, इसलिए कि पता है कि क्या चाहिए और वो क्यों चाहिए, तो फिर अगर ये दोनों पता होता तो डर कम लगता है.
फॉर यू टू जस्ट गेट इनटू अ पीरियड ड्रामा सच अ अर्ली स्टेज ऑफ योर करियर, हाउ डिफिकल्ट वाज इट फॉर यू? बिकॉज apart from the fact that there is a subtext, there's a lot of layers around it, the sort of matchbox that you're using, the sort of cigarettes that you're using, the sort of almost everything that you're using. It must have been tough to just remember everything.
That is the thing, I'll tell you what. It was challenging when I thought about doing the film.
Right.
But then just because after having so many conversations with Dibakar, I was so sure that I can, for these next 4 months, I'll do the prep for the film. And we'll get to know about the film and the character.
Right.
But I can take that leap of faith. I can improvise. I can do all sort of things that I feel like doing while I'm acting. And Dibakar will take care of it. He'll tell me that, no, do not do this. This is where you're going wrong. So just because of that faith, was I able to perform like this. And I feel that this is the most, as I've told you, this is the most honest I have ever been as an actor since 8 years of my acting career.
Does it bother you as a creative person that when certain things are inferred, जिसका कोई ऐसे आपने भी कहा कॉन्टेक्स्ट मिक्स हो जाता है, जिसका कोई फंसाने में कोई जिक्र भी नहीं था. जैसे मैंने कुछ जो चीज़ें मैंने पढ़ी जब ये सारा कि उत्तराखंड में बैन हो गई है, एंड आई रेड दैट सेम स्टेटमेंट इन सेवरल ट्वीट्स बाय लॉट ऑफ पीपल कि ये बात एकदम बिल्कुल गलत थी कि प्रलय इस वजह से आई कि एक मुस्लिम फैमिली को केदारनाथ से जाने के लिए बोल दिया गया. ये तो कोई जिक्र भी नहीं था उसका. दैट वॉज नेवर.
वही मैं कह रहा हूँ कि
जो इन्वायरमेंट का आपने जो बोला था कि भाई ओवर कमर्शलाइजेशन नहीं होना चाहिए, उसका तो कोई जिक्र ही नहीं हो रहा है.
देखिए वही जैसे 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 आपने ये बात को स्पेसिफिकली कहा, सो नाउ आई अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्टेक्स्ट. आई कैन गिव यू अ स्पेसिफिक आंसर टू दिस. एज अ सोसाइटी वी डोंट एक्नॉलेज नुआंस एंड दैट गेट्स मैनिफेस्टेड इन डिफरेंट मेजर प्रॉब्लम्स दैट वी हैव टुडे. इट इज द सेम थिंग. वी डोंट सी दैट देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ कोरिलेशन एंड अ कॉजेशन. चीजें साथ में अक्सर होती हैं. अगर ऐसा होता तो ये दो तीन चीजें साथ में होती और वो होंगी. देयर इज अ पैटर्न. इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि ये चीज ये कॉज कर रही है. सो देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन कोरिलेशन एंड कॉजेशन.
टू द फेलियर पार्ट ऑफ इट, ही गोज थ्रू अ लॉट ऑफ फेलियर्स. ही गोज थ्रू अ लॉट ऑफ टॉक दैट हिज कंटेम्पररीज लाइक कैफ एंड अदर पीपल दे हैव रीच्ड वेयर दे हैव रीच्ड. बट दैट फेलियर डेफिनेटली मस्ट हैव बीन एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर हिम फॉर जस्ट बिल्डिंग अप दैट हंगर फॉर अचीविंग व्हाट ही फाइनली अचीव्ड.
लाइक फेलियर्स इट्स एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट. I think I would value a massive failure more than a mediocre success. We are taught to be so careful. We are taught to not fail. You have to succeed. That's fine. You want to succeed, you please succeed. But being careful is the problem. You need to learn how not to be careful. You need to try different things. Only then, once in like 100 times or 200 times, you'll hit on something that's completely fresh. And that's going to change everything. For everybody. So it's extremely important to fail.
Three books, according to you, everyone must read.
School books, because that's how you... And I think people miss out on religious texts these days. I would just tell them to also read that, so as to see that there could be striking similarities between what we study now and those texts written then. Those are different layers of cryptography. It's like condensed metaphors. But if you want to see, you can see these things. So that is very fascinating. So they should also read. And the third thing that I think everyone should read is coding. Just like one language is required for any career, like doctor, you need to know English or Hindi or anything like that. In 3 to 5 years, everyone will be required to know coding.
Do you think that it's important for people to realize that just fighting over trivial issues like religion and that main tumse behtar hoon aur meri baat maanni chahiye, you think it's high time people realize that?
High time se bhi agar kuch zyada immediate time ho sakta hai to wo time hai abhi, because this is for sure, our ignorance cannot stop what is inevitable. Aur main jo inevitability ki baat kar raha hu wo hai jo abhi technology se bhi aayegi. आपको मैं एक फैक्ट देता हूँ. 65% ऑफ द किड्स हु आर गोइंग टू किंडरगार्टन दिस ईयर विल एंड अप, इफ दे एवर एंड अप हैविंग अ जॉब, विल एंड अप वर्किंग फॉर टेक्नोलॉजीज दैट आर स्टिल नॉट इन्वेंटेड येट. तो जब ऐसा होता है तो स्कूल्स को भी पता नहीं होता कि वो पढ़ाएं क्या. तो अभी हम ऐसे स्टेट पे हैं कि हमें पता ही नहीं है कि हमें पढ़ाना भी क्या चाहिए. तो हम कितना अच्छा पढ़ते हैं और आपस में हमारी रैंकिंग क्या है, ये तो इमटीरियल हो गया. मैं आपको पूरे ग्लोबल प्रॉब्लम बता रहा हूँ. हमें नया नॉलेज स्ट्रक्चर बना रहे हैं, एडुकेशन का, जिसमें हम इमोशनल क्वेश्चन पे ज़्यादा ध्यान दे रहे हैं, जिसमें हम बच्चों को ये बता रहे हैं कि अननोन सिचुएशंस में कैसे डील करें, क्योंकि हमेशा अननोन सिचुएशंस ही होंगे, क्योंकि अब रेट ऑफ चेंज इंक्रीज हो रहा है. पहले चेंज कॉन्स्टेंट था, अब रेट ऑफ चेंज इंक्रीज हो रहा है, तो हमें ही नहीं पता कि क्या होने वाला है. सो फॉर दैट योर इमोशनल स्टेबिलिटी इज़ वेरी वेरी रिक्वायर्ड. सो इमोशनल क्वेश्चन पे ज़्यादा ध्यान दिया जा रहा है. कोडिंग सिखाई जा रही है बच्चों को, क्योंकि अगर आपको कोडिंग नहीं आती 5 साल के अंदर, अभी जैसे आप, मैं कुछ भी हो सकता हूँ, कुछ भी हो सकते हैं, जैसे हमें अंग्रेज़ी आती है, हमें मैथमेटिक्स आता है, वर्किंग नॉलेज है जिससे हम लोग बात कर सकते हैं, 5 साल के बाद कोडिंग वैसी चीज़ हो जाएगी. और हमारा इग्नोरेंस, हमें नहीं पता है, लोग इस बारे में बात नहीं करते हैं, विल नॉट स्टॉप इट फ्रॉम कमिंग. अगर लोग इसके बारे में पता, सबके पास गूगल है, गूगल पे जाएं पता करें, ये सारी चीज़ें हो रही हैं, ये होंगी नहीं, हो रही हैं. एंड इट हैज़ ऑलवेज बीन लाइक दिस. फ्यूचर इज ऑलरेडी हियर, इट इज़ जस्ट अनइवनली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड. उसको पूरा आने में थोड़ा टाइम लगता है, लेकिन आ जाएगा, आज नहीं तो कल आ ही जाएगा, क्योंकि इट इज़ इनोवेटेबल, इट इज़ मैथमेटिकल, इट इज़ दैट प्रिसाइज.
आई बिलीव व्हाइल यू आर एक्टिंग यू जस्ट डिस्क्लोज योर मोबाइल फॉर आई थिंक मंथ्स एंड people can't access you and you're not invited to parties and events. That's what you've said in one of the interviews.
Yeah.
So for an actor, it is important to just totally get away from all the communication whatsoever.
I think whatever it takes, you have to have that frame of mind where you can try to create something new. So I mean, like, there can be different process to do the same thing. This was important for this particular film because the era that we are talking about is 1940s,
right,
and there was no internet. There was no phones, right. There was no mineral water, there was no automatic cars. So all the things that I could have done to start with, to break the pattern that we normally live in, I started with that, and then I worked on the characters and other nuances of the film.